Woodridge, and they are slightly groomed, but they're not fully wet grooves, are they?
They have some small grooves, and by no means are they a tire that you would ever put on the road on your road car, but they give just a little bit more traction in the gravel section. But right now, I mean, Tanner Faust, look at the beautiful driving here. I had a ride along with Jeff Ward yesterday in the Ford Fiesta, and let me tell you, Toby, it was one of the most violent experiences of my life. I've driven some really quick race cars, and never before have I experienced anything as violent as this.
On the dirt, Jeff goes a bit quiet as the transmission goes quiet. Now, the job of the shock that these drivers take when they hit the earth again is quite incredible.
It really is. I mean, the suspension does a really good job of absorbing a lot of that. But the roughest part around this track is actually right here on the asphalt. As you go through turn one, it goes up, and then you go over a crest, and then down a hill into turn one. And as you can see, there's asphalt, there's puddles, there's concrete right now going over a railroad track. So these drivers have to be so diverse to manage all these aspects.
Great sideways shots of the Hondas going through there. But it's actually not the sideways style of Tanner Faust that keeps his speed going. There you see Noni Veerman currently third position. He's got the red rear wing of that Honda as they make their way to try and get up to the tail of Steve Arpin with the orange and red Ineos Ford Fiesta. But it was a debut weekend last time out in Phoenix for the Honda crew, and they did manage to get on the podium in the second round with Sebastian Eriksson.
This car, we're going to make it lighter, and we're going to make it even more durable, so there's plenty more to come from the Honda Civic. And just riding on board there, you're really getting a good impression of just how good of a job he's doing, just hitting all his marks, hitting every single apex. Now in that gravel pit, you're going to see him flick it sideways here, a little pull of the handbrake to get the car rotated. Oh, he takes the joker left. Where is this going to place him? Is he going to come out in front of Sebastian Eriksson, or is he going to fall behind? Let's get a good view here of the Honda Civics. He's still going to be on it. We even get stays the same.
Yeah, and the wipers are struggling on the windshield for Eriksson. They're going very slowly indeed. That might be giving him a problem. Our onboard camera has got its own lens cleaning device, and we've got a great view. But everything's so lightweight, and it's a polycarbonate windscreen that they've got in these cars to save the weight. It's not glass necessarily. You can have glass, but it's not necessarily glass. And it maybe doesn't clear as well as your regular road car. But these guys, they're concentrating so hard. As we look back, Steve Arpin's Ford Fiesta. He looks so serene, as you say, Anders, but it is so violent as he takes the joker lap for his first and only time.
He does indeed, and they have to take this one time and one time only in all these semi-finals, last chance qualifier, and final and on as we enter the final lap here. He stays well ahead in second place.
So one more lap remaining around this 0.8-mile circuit just on the outskirts of downtown Dallas. They go over the railroad. Great shot as he drifts it one way, then the other, over the crest, over the camber. Rear tires smoking at 600 horsepower. It's being transmitted through those tires. You can see the exhaust in the middle of the rear bumper glowing red, nearly yellow hot. Such is the heat, such is the power from the engines. These cars are from another planet. They really are. As he comes over the jump for the final time, and he is going to be soon seeing the checkered flag, but it is going to be Tanner Faust who is taking the victory in this heat ahead of Steve Arpin. Joni Veerman gets third position. Sebastian Eriksson comes across the line in fourth, and unfortunately Brian Deagle unable to start this race after the fire that happened in the warm-up this morning about an hour and a bit ago. Again, Anders.